issues, but we pray the Lord that will bless you during the service this morning. As we worship with you, the Lord is here wherever you are in the house. The Lord is with you, and as we worship this morning, we want to give him all the praise that he deserves, because he is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the beginning and the end. We're going to have our praise and worship team lead us in worship this morning. And you at home, set aside everything that you was doing as we get ready to worship the Lord and give him the praise that he deserves.
Thank you. praise you, Lord. We are here in your presence. And this Palm Sunday, Lord, to give you the glory. Lord, we ask you to this service can be pleasing to you as good news, Lord. We make this time apart so we can be live on YouTube, Lord. So those that's not able to come in the temple will be able to assist. Lord, as we pray over the prayer, Lord, our Father, who are in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
afternoon, man.
The grass withered, the flower fades, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
We want to thank all of you who are following us, as Brother Ricardo mentioned, either via Facebook, even also YouTube. We thank the Lord for all of you on this Palm Sunday, when Jesus made his triumphal entry to Jerusalem. On this, on a day like today, he entered Jerusalem, knowing full well that in a couple of days, those who were singing in the streets, Hosanna, Hosanna, will be the same ones who's going to call crucify him. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. We want to thank our praise and worship team for such a wonderful opening of our service and a wonderful morning of praise. I pray that you at home who are watching us, that you are also edified in your moment of worship and praise. You sit along with us. I don't know about you, but I miss being in the house of the Lord. Although I've been able to worship from home for the last couple of Sundays, but it is good to be here. And I know some of you miss the fellowship of one another in the house of God. But I want to tell you this afternoon that no matter where you are at home, I want to tell you that the Lord is with you. The Lord is in your household right now. Because he's a God that has no limit, no boundaries. And you're worshiping him right now in spirit and in truth. We thank God for each and every one of you for taking this moment, set aside of time, to be able to join with us and worship. I'm going to go into a reading of a word that I'm going to share to you here this morning. I would like for you to please turn the Bibles with me to a very familiar passage, a very familiar song. I know that song by heart in the French language, because I had a mother who made us recite seven songs and sing seven songs before we go to prayer at night. So I want you to turn with me to Psalm 24. And I'm going to read out of the Amplified Version of the Bible. And I know some of you may be in the technology, so now you definitely have to find a physical Bible. And if you're watching me on your phone, it is on your screen. And you can follow along with us as I'm going to read for you Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord's, the fullness of it, the world and those who dwell in it. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the streams and the rivers. Who may ascend unto the mountains of the Lord, and who may stand in his holy place? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul to what is false, nor has sworn deceitfully. He shall receive a blessing from the Lord and a righteousness from the God of his salvation. This is the generation of those who diligently seek him and require him as their greatest need, who seek your face, even Jacob, Selah. Lift up your hands, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ancient doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your hands, O ye gates, and lift him up, ancient doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of Glory. He is the King of Glory. Words of the Lord.
Amen.
Just before we go to the word, we're going to sing a song, and I'm going to ask Brother Charles to lead us. And as soon as we do that, we will go ahead and pray and go into the Word to ask the Holy Spirit to speak through me are still seeking your face. And Father, the same move of God that is in this temple, we pray that it is in every household who are watching, who are listening to us at this very moment. Father, I pray that as the Lord may decrease, and that the Holy Spirit will speak through me. Because we know you have a word for your people who are out there. Father, let all of us that have ears, let us listen. And let this word be a word that we can use not only for today, but forevermore. In our lives, every single day. And we ask this in the mighty precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ, I pray.
Amen.
Once again, we want to say thank you to our praise and worship team. We've come together to praise and worship. They set aside the time, and such a very critical time, to devote the time. And we thank God for each and every one of them. And we pray that the Lord will continue to bless each and every one of you for the dedication, for rendering service to the ministry of God. Because I deny Baptist Church may not be able to be, but I can tell you that there's a crown of glory waiting for each and every one of you.
I can't open my screen. Yeah. I can't open my screen. My hands are locked.
I want to tell each and every one of you that Adonai Baptist youth and members, we join with the rest of this country and countries around the world, around the globe, and the concern of the evolving health crisis. In a time of great uncertainty and unprecedented time. Due to this coronavirus that is known medically as COVID-19, this is plaguing the world, the countries around us, our towns, cities, and families, and workplace are all being affected by this virus. But I also want to share with you that we are praying for those being affected by this virus. And also we are praying for all of those health workers, professionals, who work around the clock to care for those who've been affected, and also those who are very much vulnerable. I believe that we all understand that there's a need for all of us to stay healthy, physically, and mentally, but also I want to tell you this evening that our spiritual health is also important. In the passage of scripture that I just read for you in Psalm 24, the psalmist encourages all of us to build up our spiritual life by setting aside the busyness of this world, the constant noise that we encounter, the insecurity in this world, and that we need to put our trust in God. For you to understand where I want to take you with this text, is that for several months, the Philistine, they held the Ark of Covenant under lock and key. And finally, they decided that it was too hard to hold under lock and key, that they needed to send it back to where it belonged. And this psalm is an occasion to where King David was bringing the Ark of Covenant back into the city of Jerusalem. And obviously, King David did a very first field attempt. But now, after the first field attempt, King David decided that he was going to allow God to work. And he was going to listen to God's ways. And so David took out his pen and he penned down several psalms in commemoration of bringing the Ark of Covenant into Jerusalem. He penned down Psalm 24, Psalm 68, Psalm 87, and Psalm 132. Now, David had a way of getting our attention at the beginning of the psalm, Psalm 24. He established for us that God And then obviously, David went on to show his concern about the moral behavior of mankind as it is today. Throughout the Psalms, David writes so many wonderful songs. And as Christians, as believers, we have so many songs that we can rely on at this very moment when we go through some very distressing time. Like Psalm 27, for example, tells us, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is my strength in my life. Who shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat my flesh, my enemies and my foes, they will stumble and fall. The coronavirus encamped us, but we shall not fear." I just add that again, because that's what we're dealing with at this very moment. But one thing that all of us need to desire is that we will seek the Lord, and that we will want to dwell in the house of God all the days of our life. That's Psalm 27. And then it goes further on at the end of the Psalms, in verse 14, it says, "Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord." And we also have Psalm number 1, that tells us, "Blessed is the man who walk not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sit at the seat of the scornful. But his delight is what is in the law of the Lord. And that he shall meditate on it day and night. And that he will be like a tree that is planted by the rivers of waters, that will bring fruit in its season, and its leaf shall not wither." What God we serve. This is the God who is in control of the world that we live in. For all of you who are watching me in this very moment, the Lord is in control of the earth. Everything that is on the earth belongs to God. So it is important for all of us to never forget that God is sovereign. He is Lord of all. And as I delve with you into the text this afternoon, I want you to be mindful that all of us as Christians needs to be aware that every single of your Christian, because I know everyone that is listening who is following us on right now via Facebook or YouTube, not all of us you call God Father, because in order for you to call him your Father, you have to confess with your mouth that he is Lord of Lord, that he is Jesus, Lord and Savior of your life. John 1, verse 1, chapter 1, verse 79. Are the things that you bring to God is pleasing to God? Are the things that you're holding in your hand are pleasing to God this evening? And one of the things when I'm talking about quarantining ourselves, there's some of us who went into a self-quarantine stage, but now we need for God to quarantine our hands. Because we're holding too many dirty hands from this world. We are touching, we are involved with so many dirty things. We're taking things that doesn't belong to us. We're involved into so many filth. That God says, in order for you to enter into my house, if I'm going to dwell in your heart, in your life, when you come to worship to me, your hands must be quarantined. Your hand needs to be cleaned by the Holy Spirit. It needs to be quarantined by the Holy Spirit. And when we talk about clean hands, we're talking about the vanities of this world, the desires of this world. Have we separated ourselves from the things of this world? Are we still connected to the things of this world? It is not enough for us to say we have clean hands. As the text went on to tell us, it also asks that we need to have a pure heart. Listen, if we're going to receive the righteousness of Jesus Christ, if we're going to truly bask in the presence of God and enjoy the joy of his salvation, our hands, our heart needs to be clean. And listen to what the psalmist says in Psalm 66, verse 18. If we regard iniquity in our heart, God will not hear us. So we need to come to God with not only our hands pure, clean, but also the heart. We need to be clean to receive God. Listen, I want to tell you that as many clean hands that we have in our society around the world, but I'm telling you, there's going to be a lot of people with sanitizing hands where clean hands are still going to go to hell. Because we clean our hands just so we can come to church. But the reality is, our hearts are not cleaned. Our hearts are still filled with dirt, with a whole bunch of things of this world, with the desires of this world. So this morning we need to quarantine our hands. When I talk about quarantine, we need to be set apart. Our hands, our hearts need to be set apart for God. To be used by God. So when we enter into worship, we lift up our hands towards heaven, that those hands are truly pure and clean. That it will not be entered with filth, with things that we know we shouldn't be involved in. So this morning we need to clean our hands with dirt. We need to get rid of a lot of things in our hands this morning. This morning I want to tell you that we need to allow God to quarantine our hands, church. We need to allow God to quarantine our hearts. We need to allow for God to quarantine our minds. We need to allow God to quarantine our spirits, people. We need to allow God to quarantine our eyes, our ears. Because the music we're listening to, the things we're watching with those eyes, that we know they are not pleasing to God. They're not godly. And then the other thing that we need to do is, we need to say, not my will, but God, your will. God, not my plan, but your plan, oh God. Not my desire, but your desire, oh God. God wants to be in charge of your life. He wants to order your steps. He wants to direct not let him to quarantine your hands, if you do not allow him to quarantine your heart, he will not be Lord of your life. All of you do is just motions. There's no purity coming out of worship. You just an act. You just act. And I say that because sometimes we want to do self-quarantine, but it's not the quarantine that God wants to do, the complete cleanliness, the completely setting us apart from the things of this world. The psalmist says it at the very beginning. The earth is the Lord's, and everything that is within it, that is in it, is the Lord's. God so much didn't want us to be, have any say in the world. When we go back to Genesis, you know when he created man? On the sixth day. That's how much he didn't want us to have a say. That's how much he didn't want us to feel like, you know, we can control him. We can control the dynamic of this world. On the sixth day. So my brothers and sisters who are watching me, who are listening to me, God wants to have control. He wants to quarantine your life this morning. By pointing your life, he wants to set you apart. He wants to call you his. He wants to have a relationship with you. I remember a couple of Sundays ago when I shared with the youth that we're living in a day and age where we're hearing more epidemics and nowadays. I can remember when I lived on the island that there was old people that used to die. But now, the young ones, it doesn't matter what age. God wants to have all of your clean hands in your pure heart. He wants to get rid of all the impurity. He wants you to turn away from sin. And he wants you to come. When you come in, and says he will fight all your battles. He is strong and mighty. He will protect you. He is your redeemer. He's our redeemer. And just as on this Palm Sunday, he made a triumphal entry with the blood, that's what we need to quarantine our hands this morning. Not hand sanitizer. Not water and soap, but the blood of Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, God wants to be in charge of your life. And as I said a little bit earlier, he wants to order your steps. He wants to direct your life. But he cannot come in if you're still holding on to things of this world. If your hands are still dirty, if your heart is still not pure, the only way for him to come in, if you will take this moment in time right now and confess to him that he is Lord, Lord of all, the creator of this universe, and you want him to come into your heart and life, and you want him to save. That's the only way. You can sit right now with me, no matter where you are. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart and my life and save me. I want to be yours. I want to live for you. I want to worship you. I want, when I come into your temple and worship you, that my hands are clean and that my heart is totally dedicated to you. That is the only way. And if you say that right now, no matter where you are, he hears you. And he's actually in your heart and your life right now. That's the God, the living God, the creator of this universe. I want you to sing with me in a few minutes a song that's been on my heart for the last several days, several weeks, that it is, we need to give all to Jesus. Sometimes we feel as if though the things of this world cannot wait, but I'm here to tell you, if you give it to God, everything else can wait. If you don't do it, it can be too late. So this evening, what we need to do right now is we need to sing along with me. Give me you
everything else can wait. Give me you. My hope is not to wait. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you.
That's what I'm doing.
Give me you. Everything else can wait.
become Lord and Savior of your life right now. The moment you pray that prayer. And if you've not made a decision, tomorrow's not guaranteed. The next few seconds are not guaranteed to anyone of us. With this pandemic going around and as much safety as we're trying to keep our social distancing, young people are dying. People who seem to who are very healthy are dying. We don't know where this is going. Right now, all we need to do is to be ready if you call us. I believe that nothing will happen to those that if it's not God that ordained it to happen. But what's more important right now is my life quarantined to the things that God wants me to be as a child of God. So when I call him, when he called me, my life, my hands, my heart, ready to receive into his presence. Father God, we thank you. We exalt your holy name. Father, this Palm Sunday as you enter triumphantly into Jerusalem. As the psalmist David, King David mentioned to said in the psalm, that you created the heaven and earth. All of it is yours. But if we want to enter into your presence, we got to have clean hands and a pure heart. Father, I pray that all of those who are watching us, who are following the service, that they will make that commitment to have clean hands and pure hearts. Not only just for the moment and not because they hear the word, but that will dwell with them every single day of their lives. There are some of us that need to come back to you, Lord. And the beautiful thing is, Father, you there ready with open arms. And for those, I want to tell you that God is waiting for you. He's waiting for you. He wants to call you his once again. He wants to be your father. So no matter where you are right now, he's seeking to have a relationship with you. In this moment of so much uncertainty, people are losing their jobs. There's this business closing.